Hi.
Hi. So I'm gonna show you the lists.
I can split it in game if you want. Or you can share screen, it's up to you.
I'll go share screen, it's fine.
Okay. So, what do they play? Oh yeah, show me. So, this deck is awful, first of all. Like, Vol Creeper is bad, Ragnaros is bad, Sylvanas is not needed in this deck. Halazir is okay-ish. But yeah, their build is pretty wacky.
Okay, what else?
And both George C and Bonnie Hover play this?
Yep.
Okay. George C.
This is Druid. It's one
It's
nourish.
one wish, one Mari Keeper, that's interesting, and Flare Out
And
Rage.
Emperor Sylvanas. It's my list, and they just play Sylvanas or Emperor of Nourish. Okay, it's pretty normal. What's this?
Sorbet and Ketun, what the fuck is this shit?
It's probably against OTK, but yeah, it's kind of bad.
You played Ketun. I didn't play this deck that much. You know the matchups.
I played Double Revenge. I didn't Doomsayer. And what else? Then they have Freeze.
What the fuck?
So they just want to beat ODK, I guess. So what's Daybear Ban gonna be? Do they ban Shaman? They
Yeah,
do.
they ban Shaman for sure. Right?
Probably, yeah. Like they can ban Druid, like they are also kind of weak against Druid, but like their Shaman is kind of good against Druid because they have 7/7s for 4 in the Shamblers.
Yeah, at least in their mind it's good against druids. Like they all think it is.
Yeah, so they will ban Shaman, so I should ban the Freeze, I guess, because I have OTK over Dragon Warrior.
Yeah. Your lineup is weaker than mine against theirs because they kind of counter your OTK.
Yeah. Yeah, against their lineup it kind of sucks, yeah. Okay.
Dragon Warrior is good against wacky decks.
Alright, the Dragon Warrior is good against this lineup, yeah.
You should ban your Shaman. Yeah. They kind of also counter Zoo, right?
Yeah, they counter Zoo heavily.
Heavily. But yeah, I was like,
Okay.
they
They
banned
banned
Druid.
Druid, yeah.
I was thinking that it's good to ban Freeze if they have Freeze and Control Shaman so that you can get your win with Zoo easier. Because like Zoo probably beats their Ketun Warrior, right?
Well, beats, I think it's close. Like normally you have like 45, so now you have like 50 because it's kinda shitty, but so I start with Shaman and the Zoo because we both are playing the deck and like
Yeah.
because it's more important, so let's start with Shaman or
I mean,
whatever.
is it important what deck you start with usually? Like in Conquest, it's random, kind
In
of.
Conquest, if they pick random, maybe we also pick random, so okay,
I
so
mean, you can order it for coin. Because like usually it's like one game with coin, one game with no coin.
no, it's random as well. Whether you have coin or not.
It's not really random, it's usually like one game with one.
No, it's random completely. Obviously, it's
Yeah, I like
chain.
keeping Tusker. Do you ever keep double Tusker?
I don't know. That's like what I wanted to ask. Probably
Might be
not.
okay.
Like, what do they have? They have one Doomsayer, double
Yeah.
Beckoner, They have all the cartoon cards. Whoa, what are they not running? They don't run Bran. And they don't run Gorehowl.
Do they run double brawl?
Yeah, okay, I can. Double totemic, like, maybe it's not bad, like,
Yeah.
let's keep double, yeah, okay.
It's bad if they have Fairy War, actually, if they have the C'Thun guy, the 3-mana guy. But usually it shouldn't be that
They run only one slam. Just play the totem golem, right?
Do you?
I don't know, probably, yeah, right.
Yeah, it's too strong not to play. It's bad only versus the Doomsayer, which they might have because they kept the cards, but they can also
They
like
run
keep.
only one Doomsayer, so it's.
Yeah.
And it's not that bad because I don't have one drop, so I'm not missing that much. It's like one for one.
Okay. Now you're missing quite a bit, but you still have good curve. But Tusker is really good against Warrior. Especially if he task if he goes Disciple Phase. Why would they play Disciple Phase? They have another one?
Maybe,
Probably.
probably, yeah.
It's good if they have another one.
Or they could have chosen and won a contest.
Yeah, now it's pretty good. Bit abusive. If you hit like a mana type or something here, you instantly win the game.
I need to try it, I guess. I think the ghoul would be too devastating, right?
Yeah. I think it's okay to trade. They don't have weapon removal, so when you hit Doomhammer, you kind of crushing. Golem Hero Power.
Well, hero power for sure.
That
Now
makes the
I
cards
play
tough.
Golem, right? Because I can trade a 1-1.
Yeah, for sure. It's pretty insane. Second goal would be really bad.
So I can storm, trade a board, hero power and fin from below.
Yeah, I like that too. Because you don't want to like
Yeah,
flame tongue yet.
everything is worse.
It doesn't even matter how you hit. A good one.
Does it matter from which side I buy? From left, right?
Yeah, left. Custom and spawn on right. Wow, that's so bad. You just flame tongue hero power and hit his face.
I will flame tongue. If I hit the spell power, I probably lava burst and go face.
So then you spell your hero power first.
Yeah, and if I don't, then I just flame tongue and go face.
I think it's good to flame tongue face.
Yeah, it's a lot of damage.
You don't play into brawl. It's a lot of damage. He's pressured.
They also, have... especially if I, because I have taunt now, because now he cannot shield block shield slam and attack the flame tongue. Because yeah,
I still wonder why they played the turn three Pitons chosen. It's pretty weird.
Yeah, like yeah, probably playing badly.
Double lava burst is like insanely good against warrior. They still have druid though, by the way. Like you see that they full contact Zoo. That's the issue. Like everybody's gonna play druid, so like if they full contact your Zoo, you just need to still be druid. It's not that bad.
Yeah.
Still, druid is not easy matchup, but it's favored. So
oh, it's so super close.
Yeah, but it's better than freeze mage and shit.
Yeah. Okay.
Can you double trade to play around Brawl, or is it too much?
Is it even better against Brawl? Because, like, if... Like, I miss 3 damage, so... And obviously the Brawl outcomes are better, but...
Actually, if you play Tunnel Trog, isn't that enough to get Little next turn with double Lava Burst?
So you just... what?
Tunnel Trog hero power? If it's enough to kill him next turn, why not?
Because he can gain 10 very likely, or play the twins, because he top deck the cartoon card and he already played one, so I would develop as strong board as I can. Like, what I would do is just track faceless hero power and go face for free. And if he draws, yeah, whatever.
Okay.
Because I always feel that if they play like the Twin Emperor, because it's super likely they have it.
I was saying that it's more likely that he has Brawl, but...
Then cartoon card? Like he has 2 cartoon cards left and he played one like without any use. So for me it's kind of obvious he has another. Good one. Spell power.
Too bad.
I could keep the truck maybe, but it was...
Wouldn't really help. That's what I wanted, to keep the 7-7. If he does spell power, you could lava burst face here.
Shouldn't I rogue bite? No, never ever, right?
No. No way. You want Doomhammer. That's the only way you win now.
Yeah.
Now if he has Cartoon card on the top, you insta lose. He had it.
Yeah, like it was obvious he has it, like.
Still not sure if I like that turn.
But would we win against this, like, if we wouldn't develop the 7-7?
I mean, if I would develop the 7-7, then I would just double trade my guys into the 4-2 to make the brawl a bit better.
Like, is it that better? Because you missed 3 damage.
Okay, but so, if your 7-7 wins, you win the game.
And if Trog wins... Then he could like trade it with War Axe, but yeah.
We can go after the game and talk about that turn.
Yeah, we will talk obviously about it. Okay.
This game is like hard now.
Yeah, the game is basically over unless I top deck Doomhammer now. Yeah, like, I wouldn't beat his deck anyway, I guess. Shaman again.
How is Druid against Fizmesh, by the way?
I think Druid is small favorite.
Okay.
Well, it's very close. Like, are you running double idol?
Yeah, and Feral Rage.
Yeah, then you are small favorite. It's a lot about like these cards. And do you run double nourish?
Yes.
Yeah, these are like the best cards. Just to draw a lot because it's very grindy matchup. Okay, full mulligan, right?
Yeah.
Or he's control.
Yeah.
Should I have kept something? Probably not, right?
No, because he has the hex. They still run hex.
Yeah.
You could keep 7/7 if you'd have like 1+2. 1, 2, and 4, you'd keep 7/7 then. Still, the chance of him having hex for the on turn 4 is small because he doesn't mulligan for hex. They mulligan for like removal.
Yeah, elemental destruction, yeah.
Yeah. Lava shock. Feral.
I felt always when I played a control shaman that Totem Golem was super annoying for me.
They have Stormquark usually.
They don't run Stormquark at all.
When I played Control Shaman, I felt the deck is not that good because you run out of threats. It's only good if they ignore your threats. If you kill their minions all the time, or if you try to kill the minions all the time, they'll lose value from faceless.
It's so interesting. They really don't run the Stormcrack.
Yeah, you play Abusive, right?
Yeah.
Abusive is really good because if you play the Totem Golem on 2,
yeah.
then
I can kill him,
Yeah, Flametongue fucks him. I know he's fucked. They're fucked if they have, if they Doomsayer and shit. Because you curve like Flametongue into Faceless, so they have no answer for that. And when you play Zoo, you can curve Councilman, and they usually don't have an answer, a good answer for that either.
So what do I do here?
You Trog, right? Or are you afraid that you're gonna get Elemental Destruction?
I'm thinking, like, I probably play Trog, right?
I like Trog because then next turn is Faceless no matter what. And then you follow up with Tusker.
Yeah.
So you
don't
have time
to
troll.
I like the troll as well. Where do I put him? Does it matter?
Ideally on the middle or the left. I think the middle.
The abusive is going to be best in the middle, or isn't it?
Yeah, put him on the right. It's okay on the right.
Yeah, I would put him on the right.
Yeah. He cannot even Elemental Destruction because he doesn't have...
He can play Doomsayer and Ancestral Spirit, right?
I mean, they need to have that.
It's so strong combo, like...
Yeah, it's like saying they can Pyro Equality. They don't always have that.
Yeah, obviously.
And they don't mulligan for Ancestral, they mulligan only for Doomsayer. While with Paladin, you mulligan for both Pyro and Equality.
Yeah.
Small chance.
So now I play just 7/7, right?
Yeah. I don't know. Some people told me that the matchup is favored for Aggro Shaman, this one.
Like, for midrange, it's definitely true, because we have Hex. I mean, if you just Hex some of these minions, then just fuck them. And Aggro, I don't know, like...
You have Doomhammer. They have no answer for Doomhammer.
Yeah. Like, they have a little bit greedy version. They have one Ragnaros, and like the Stormcrack absence is probably huge.
Yeah, their version is garbage. Like, their version is absolutely garbage.
Like, it's more grindy, so they want to beat, let's say, I don't know, Druids maybe, or...
I think even Zui is not that bad against this. It's pretty bad, but not that bad. Not as bad as it could be.
Like, they have double wave. So...
How is there OTK Warrior versus this?
I think it's like 50-50 probably.
Kranos playing OTK Warrior, he says like it's like highly favored against Control Shaman.
Like it really depends like on the version. Like they run the Shamblers, which are really good against OTK.
Shambler is a bad card, like I played with Control Shaman and like so many
like,
times.
In general it's bad, yeah, but against OTK it's like super annoying.
Yeah. Now you need to be careful at destruction.
Yeah.
Fiendly should be good enough, right? You cannot kill him, right? Yeah.
14. Can put him at 5. It's no point putting him at 5, right?
Yeah. So just Finley and get like life tap would be good.
Life
this
tap
one's,
or Hunter?
Yeah. So Hunter. That's good. Now he's forced to go like Destruction and Lava Shock.
He can Healing Wave gain 14.
Healing Wave is just delaying the... But he needs to have like exactly removal and Lava Shock. That's the issue with the deck. Like you don't always draw Lava Shock, and if you don't draw Lava Shock, then you're fucked.
Yeah, I've played a lot with the deck, and I also didn't feel it's good enough.
Like it looks good on paper if you always have the answers and stuff.
Like it was good when it was new that you had like surprise factor and people didn't know how to play against it. And it's not that bad on the ladder because people are mulliganing, like, because they think they're playing aggro shaman, while on this tournament I wouldn't ever bring it.
Yeah. I mean, it's not that bad of a deck to bring, but I think even Druid beats it. Druid just kills your minions. Thing from Below is also awful in that deck because you don't get to hero power that much.
I think you do. It's not bad. Okay, they're playing Storm or Destruction or...
But they cannot even Lava Shock next turn.
They cannot, no, they are locked next turn. Okay.
So you wanna fuck them up really badly. So you go like, just play your minions.
I play Taskar Totemic for sure.
I think you just play everything and then you Doomhammer. Just play the Flame Tongs in the middle, Abusive on the right, and then next turn you go Doomhammer Hero Power.
The Flametongue is gonna deal 2 extra damage next turn, right? Because I already have one. So with Flametongue, I deal 2 extra.
What?
Like, if I play Flametongue now, I deal 2 extra damage next turn only.
Yeah, yeah.
So if I use Hero Power, but I will miss the Hero Power the next turn, so yeah. Or...
Yeah, you want the Flametongues in the middle, right? So they can buff each other, so they can buff
Yeah, but I'm curious, like, if I use the Hero Power instead, and Doomhammer and another Hero Power, I deal same amount of damage and I'm not overextending.
Yeah, but when are you gonna play the second one?
Like, probably, like, even after some removal or whatever. Like, the next turn, like, I will Doomhammer Hero Power.
It's not really the same amount of damage, it's too less, right?
No, it's the same. Because now,
Flametongue is 4.
Now I've dealt 2 extra. No,
but,
now
no,
I'm dealing 9, and otherwise I would be dealing
11.
11, and I would miss. Oh, only one hero power. Yeah, then I've missed 2 damage. Oh, it's so bad.
I told you.
Yeah, I've miscounted.
Yeah.
And then it was really bad.
I like, probably still end up winning.
I'm not sure, like, now if he plays Taunt...
They need to have the second heal,
or he can play, like, the 7-8 and, like, Death Fertilite, so I cannot get through it. I can heal again.
It's probably not good enough. Wow. Wrecked. Yeah, but you should have played Flametongue.
Yeah,
right?
I should have played Flametongue. I've miscounted the damage. I just read that. Okay, so let's take Zoom.
You can take a Warrior if you want.
I don't know. I want to, like, for sure, like, to make sure that we will, like, use the decks we both play so it's, like, more entertaining for us.
Okay, this matchup is interesting. I mean, this is, like, easy full mulligan, but. I think Constantine is like insane in this matchup.
Yeah, Constantine is good and Seachant is very good.
Seachant, do you keep it?
Probably not, but like...
Well, if you hit the one, it's okay.
I always feel that the destruction doesn't kill it, so...
Yeah, Distortion kills the Consummon though.
Like it's coin flip most of the time, but then yeah, here he is, the one drop.
Well, I told you, like, the biggest thing with this action is that you need Lava Shock with it to be good. This is interesting. So next turn you're gonna play Constantman, right?
Yeah, and the turn after I will play Peddler plus Squire. I will take the power of a Helming because I need to kill the minions, right?
Yeah, it's better than Soulfire. Good. But if you had like Soulfire, Flame Imp and some shit, you'd probably take Soulfire, right, over the Flame Imp?
I guess so.
I don't like Flame Imp here that much.
I clear it every day, right?
Yeah.
Like the healing, I like her keeping because it doesn't do anything.
Yeah, but this one is annoying.
Yeah,
because
this
of
one is dangerous, obviously.
LDD. Farsight can be annoying because they can like elemental destruction and
yeah,
lava
yeah,
shot.
There are
for
so
zero.
Many things. Okay, so what are the options? Like Peddler plus 2 1 drops,
or boss,
or boss.
I like Peddler a bit more.
Yeah,
put more
I also like Peddler more because I put more power on the board.
Yeah, you probably want a Doomguard next turn. And it's the same thing, actually. Would you ever take Priestess?
I think I never take Flame Imp, and Priestess and Villager are kind of close. Because
yeah, Villager is cool because he has a Death Rattle, but it's not that relevant. And Priestess...
Priestess has one extra power, which is good, like, because if he doesn't clear the next turn, then it's good, and also he can storm, theoretically, so it's good that if I buff the Peddler, it can survive, and if I buff the... I would take a Priestess here, I guess.
Priestess is fine, but I like Possess, too.
Yeah, like, Villager was also good.
Super closed.
Yeah.
Close. Do you have the 2-1 on that side or on the other side of the Squire, though? I think you'd rather trade the Squire and protect the 2-1.
Isn't it that if I play the Direwolf, I want to try to die it? Because I will clear the big minion?
Do you?
Probably, yeah, right.
I guess it's fine. But usually you want to, like, protect that card. Oh, it actually mattered.
Yeah, now I have 2-1 instead of 1-1. It's great.
The chance of the cost redacted card being Lava Shock is so small, so I guess he's overloaded. I really like Doomguard next turn.
Probably,
because
yeah.
if
it's
you
a
don't
lot of
the
damage,
other one,
yeah,
you fuck him up. And before you just free out this shitty deck. That's the issue with this wacky deck.
Well, like if... With the only case, it's gonna be super difficult, but yeah.
Wow, he coined the Doomsayer. It's greedy.
So what can we do? Can Defender plus PO or not? Just Defender or Doomguard. I guess I like the Doomguard the most.
Yeah, Doomguard just puts most damage.
Sucks, I've discarded Doomguard.
Yeah, at least to keep PO. It's not the worst that can happen.
Yeah.
You can still kill him next turn if he doesn't have LED.
Well,
and even if he has a mental distraction, it's a high chance to get a minion that he can play with Argus and then you like push and then he's overloaded. He probably doesn't have Lava Shock in his hand.
Well, if he plays the distraction here. Okay, oh, he can damage the Doomguard and then win, like. The lottery to kill it. It would be real bad, but yeah. Okay.
Now they're fucked.
That's lethal, right? I guess. Oh.
That was like the fire sighted card, okay. Good to know. They only have 4 mana next turn, and no cost deducted card. Do you push?
You mean with PO? So I deal 6.
You'd PO the Squire though, but. I'm not sure if you want to push with PO. But.
Do I PO the Squire? I can PO the 2-1. Develop both, so I deal 7 with Concealment. 13.
I mean, why would you not PO the Squire over the 2-1?
Because where do I put defender? Yeah, I want to buff the Doomguard, right? With the defender.
Oh, I swing you on above that one. Maybe you just tap and defend there.
Yeah.
I don't think the
Oh,
Void Walker is that great.
whoa. Now I play Console Man, right?
I think so. Yeah, Consummate looks good. I don't think the extra HP on Doomguard is that important. They don't have any cost-reducted cards, so they cannot go like...
Well, they could go like Lava Shock plus Elemental Destruction and kill it.
Then they're still overloaded, so you will still win. Because you can two-turn lethal him. They need to have like Lava Shock, Elemental Destruction, get lucky twice on Consummate and then Doomguard, and then like have another Lava Shock for next turn.
Yeah, like this is fine. Like, obviously, if I draw the con another console mana, it's perfect. Yeah, it's
Yeah.
like no doubt about it.
Let's hope they don't high roll. They didn't high roll, so they got fucked.
They dead? 7,
I
9,
think it
10,
is, yeah,
11,
it is. It's
15, 8.
exactly it. Good deck.
It's exactly the good matchups for the deck, so. Well, now the ODK is kind of probably gonna be even more difficult, but yeah.
I never played it, so I cannot really help you that much, but
Yeah, obviously.
I mean, I'll help you like the Hearthstone and obvious things, but I don't know the depths of the deck.
But I have the turret left, so I should be the death if necessary. That early? Probably not.
I feel like it's probably annoying for that deck.
Kite is so good for against everyone. So they run Hex. Lava Shock Storm. It's completely fine. This turn's also fine.
You're clear, right?
Can also draw a lot with Rampage, but I can play Pyromancer Rampage. It's also not bad. That's 6/5. Then I coin. These are dead. It's probably even better. What did I use? One Inner Rage and one Rampage.
What do you need to win?
Well, like now I still have a lot, so now I still have 52, 48, and now I still have over 40 damage combo in the deck, so it's fine. Okay.
Just a charge inner rage and faceless, it's enough usually.
I also have Taskmaster left. So, maybe I should do. I rather have 2-1 damage, right? Because of Battle Rage, I can direct. No, but I would kill it with the Ghoul. I will draw with the two Ghouls, okay.
The difference is not big between 1 and 2 HP versus this deck.
What?
There's no difference, right, between 1 and 2 HP against his deck.
No, 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 like he can roll the 1-1, it's the only different thing.
Okay, yeah. No, but then it die. Actually, your minion can die to the second ghoul.
Yeah, I rather have two because now I play ghoul and battle rage the next turn.
Yeah, yeah.
But if I wouldn't have the ghoul in the hand, then I would probably rather have a damage because I would battle rage right on the spot.
Yeah, yeah.
Cards, I have 8, so I have 7, then draw 3, so I will have 9. That's perfect. Overloaded. Double commanding shout left. So I wanna cycle it, I guess. If I Emperor here, the next one I have 9 mana, so it's 2, 4, 8, so I can play the 4, 6, 8, 32, and I can get through one town, it's fine I guess.
Yeah, discard all your combo cards, right? Do you run two Rampages?
No, I run one only. I have Tusk, so I have 10 as combo.
Oh, you have Tusk, okay.
But yeah, it's exactly. But I'm threatening with Little right away.
Yeah. And even the one damage is not easy for him to deal it, by the way. That's often a problem for that deck.
But he needs to set up two towns, which I don't think it's possible for him. Because I can War Axe and execute and kill him for 32.
Yeah. I totally like this deck, is like they build it wrong, it's too greedy. I'm not even sure if it beats the standard things.
16, yeah. It's 32, it's lethal, it's fine. Over 7-8. Or they can, oh, they can run this.
Well, I need your Pyromancer combo, right?
Yeah, I need to draw the pyro hand here. I need to kill the one thing from below to avoid copying crit, right?
So just go ham next turn.
The next turn I will probably clear the board, and the turn after I will kill them. So how many spells can I play next turn? 2, 3. It's gonna be 5 somehow. I get fatigue already? Not yet, right?
No. Yeah, should look cruel. And you shouldn't die. Wow. Mega wrecked. Even if they roll taunt, they still lose, right?
Yeah, it's 24 exactly if they would roll taunt.
Wait.
It still would be exactly, but yeah.
Now you make them feel regret for bringing that shaman deck.
Maybe we can all watch the games together.
Yeah, you can call them if they want.
Okay.
So like see their perspective too.
Okay, they want to play another match, it's fine.
Okay.
Let's play the same. Was it better for me if I would expect they ban the druid to play versus freeze than versus warrior or not? Like
Depends how is OTK against freeze?
Like ODK against freeze is terrible, it's like 20.
Okay.
And against the control warrior, it's like 35. The zoo. How is zoo against freeze? Like 40 or less?
Less. 30, I would say.
And against cartoon, it's like 50, 45.
It's not bad against cartoon.
Okay, same band, so it's so weird that so many players brought like non-tier decks.
Yeah, I expected people to want to go fancy.
Why?
And they will just lose to themselves. And people that play the standard lineup just make it fancy. Like, look at Game King's decks. They're so awful.
So what do I keep? The Voidwalker is shitty, right? It's only one power. It's the same, like, same decks.
Okay. Yeah, Voidwalker is shitty.
Squire is fine, right? It's survival.
Yeah, she has Death Rattle. Yeah, she's okay. I mean, Divine Shield, same shit.
Yeah, it's the same.
Keep one card. Do you ever go like Squire into Alpha? Squire possessed into Alpha?
Probably, yeah, right.
It's pretty bad to Doomsayer. But then you have PL, so now it might be okay. I mean, you have to be decent, right? You have to play the
Like,
hand.
If I play two one drops and he Doomsayer, I just tap. It's not bad, right?
Yeah, it's fine. But you should play Possessed, yeah.
Like, I would always play Possessed here.
Yeah, usually you play Possessed, especially when you have PL. You don't play against Warriors. If you sometimes leave them open, you should never play Squire on one, because...
Yeah, but Valkyrie, I guess. Right. So now I would just play Direwolf and go face with both.
Yeah, I don't mind it. I don't think it's worth killing the...
No, it doesn't do anything for him.
Okay.
It just increases the chance that he will roll, like, something better, but... I don't
Farsight is, like, a dangerous card.
Yeah. Now I just develop the boss and go face for 6.
Yeah, also, like, having Squire on the left is really good for the boss, because it sets up Dargus.
So I put boss on the left, right?
Totally. Yes. I mean, you always want to put boss on the left.
Yeah, it's in general, like, sometimes there are exceptions, but yeah, that's my impression about it.
Yeah,
position.
Yeah, of course. But you usually want to do it on the left, because if you play it on the right and he gets damaged, then he spawns minions on his right and he ends up being in the middle, and then Direwolf is shit.
Yeah, exactly.
But of course, you can position for Argo sometimes. But it's really good for Argus too. Oh, this gets dirty.
Well, I will just Argus the boss and hope.
That's pretty good. I mean, that's the thing with Zoo, like, your board is, like, annoying and sticky, so, like, he doesn't even have, like, that much gain from, like, clearing it, but he has to clear it.
Like, now I have, like, a really good board against AoE, right?
Okay. Oh, he went 4. Unlucky. Top decks Lava Shock. Still has the far-sighted cards. But now he lost.
Oh.
Before you just go 6-0 against that shit. I guess the shaman beats Dragon Warrior. Bit.
Does it? I don't feel it.
I was saying, like, why would they run Sylvanas and Rag? It's good against Dragon Warrior, but it's still, like, super slow even against that.
Against Druid, they want to beat the Druid, I guess. So what do I want? How good is Doomhammer? It's probably super good, right?
Yeah, but usually you don't want to keep it without having early game.
Really? I just feel it's so good.
Okay, so you want to keep Doomhammer and just...
Because, like, every time at turn 5, I'm overextending into AoE, but, like, Doomhammer is exactly what you want.
But then you should throw away the other two cards.
I will mulligan the two remaining cards, but I will...
Okay, okay. Yeah, I'm a fan of keeping Doomhammer usually in these matchups. In, like, versus Freeze, versus Rogue sometimes, versus One Pro Shaman.
Versus Rogue, it's junk, it's obvious, but...
It's junk what? The, like, Doomhammer?
Yeah, like, keeping it.
Really? It's so good.
Against Rogue, I don't feel so. It's more about, like, having one and two drop and, like, dealing the damage. Because they can race back. Well, so, like, you would full mulligan here, or?
We can keep the Doomhammer.
Yeah, I would keep the Doomhammer every time here.
Full mulligan is also not bad, because, like, you have high chance of hitting Doomhammer by 5. Okay, this is perfect. Of course, if I had Squire and Totem Golem or just Totem Golem, I would instantly keep Doomhammer.
Yeah.
But, like, against Rogue, wouldn't you keep it if you have, like, Totem Golem?
Like, if I would have Perfect Curve, then yeah, but if I would have only Totem Golem, like, on a play, then no. Like, I feel like playing 1-drop is so huge against Rogue.
He loses to to Flame Tongue here. Okay, this is good, too. That was a ballsy Doomsayer.
Oh, like, it gained 7, so it's not super disaster. Okay. Is the 7-7 sucks. Now we can rattle it. I need two Pharaohs here, right?
Pharaohs leaves you with blanks.
But, like, cannot, like, pass here. I think I should just have to go do as much face damage as I can. And...
Yeah, just go Ferals and hope for top deck. It's a pretty bad spot. 7-7 is pretty good.
Well, if he doesn't have the copy stats with Taunt, then, like, it's not that.
And the copy with Taunt is not even that great now at 5 HP. Yeah. Yeah, just double his face. You're never gonna touch that card again. His guy. You consider trading Squire?
Probably not. I'm just considering it. Because if he copied the toughness, how big is the difference whether he has 7 or 5? 4 or 5. It's not that big, right? He has elemental destruction, he can kill it anyway, so it's fine. If he copy it now... Huh. It probably sucks if he copies 7-5. Maybe the Doomhammer's too risky to keep.
On a coin, I would definitely keep it, but.
Yeah.
Some is not that great.
Well, it was good.
Because he high rolled.
Was lucky, so it was good. Says 4 mana? I don't want to kill the 7/7 for sure, because then he could, like... And that's the reason why I don't want to put anything. I would just Doomhammer, kill the 1/1 and go face for free.
Yeah. Yeah, you don't want to kill 7/7 for sure, because if you kill it, then he gets that.
I don't want to give him the opportunity to kill it as well.
Fox, that can be threatening.
If he has a heal, I will lose for sure. Just Totem and Horse Rider.
If you play Horse Rider, you give him the chance to get a Shambler. What can you play around it?
I will roll, like, for sure, right?
Yeah.
So now we will see. So bad. How bad is Shambler? It's super bad for me, right?
Yeah. But it's weird to not play anything.
Not developing?
But they cannot win. I mean, you need to top deck or bite. Like, maybe you can scare him somehow to, like, kill his minion or something like that.
Because even if he has, like, the copy, the 5 mana, it's also better for him to trade away, and but if he copies 7/7, it's still fine, okay. I don't know. This is close. I will probably just do it like this.
On another hand, it's like fine to play Horse Rider, because even if he trades that and plays the Shambler, then you still have a double thing from below.
Yeah, but I have it here as well. Like, what's the difference? And if he's not kind of develop the 7/7 with Taunt, it's good for me. Like, I have second Doomhammer. Okay, so now he's gonna resummon two of these, right?
No, you never kill it.
Okay. Then I have 10.
You would have won if you wouldn't have the heal.
Taunt.
You might just Trog and Horse Rider and Dog Biter.
And go face for 10.
Yeah.
Yeah. Is it good to use the Rock Biter?
Maybe you can keep it.
I would keep it, like, for sure, for at first, like, if he has Healing Wave, he's not gonna have, like, full refill.
Yeah, you're probably not gonna have mana problems. Yeah, you can keep it, it's fine. You wanna usually use it if you have, like, burst in your hand and you're afraid of taunt, or if you're afraid
but
of
I don't have like a burst in the hand, so like let's say if he Hala Seal and Elemental Destruction, then it's good, like, that I have more damage in my hand.
I mean, he's never gonna play that.
What?
Hala Seal and Elemental Destruction on this board.
Why? He's gonna heal back and stay with 2/7/7s, so why wouldn't he? Yeah, now it's good, like, that he didn't refill, like...
Now he's gonna trade your 2/1, or is he gonna go
and
base?
Like, you wanna trade into 2/1, right, to get 2/7/7s, right?
Yeah. Either way, you're not dead, so maybe you can set up a 2-turn, 26 damage level, but it's pretty hard.
It's kind of hard.
You just go all face and play the thing from below, probably.
Yeah.
But top deck might affect play. That's greedy as fuck. Now you just ignore it. And it's actually not gonna do that much bad for you. Because you cannot die. You lose for the mental destruction, but fuck it.
Okay.
I think you just go all out, right? Or do you see like another nifty play?
Okay, if I use Rook Biter, deal. Or I can play Doom Attack, play
Doom
Hammer.
Yeah, you definitely play Doom Hammer this turn.
And use Hero Power, right? And start with the Hero Power.
Yeah. If it's Spell Power, you can consider killing Halazil.
And how?
With
a Lightning Bolt. And then attacking it once.
And then attack face, and then maybe you just go double thing from below and not Doomhammer. Ah, no, you can play one thing from below and Doomhammer. Is that worth it, though?
Yeah, it's good again around AoE, I guess.
Okay. I'm not sure, I think you lose to AoE anyways. But yeah, Doomhammer, and I'll play one of them. I think you lose to AoE anyways, like if he has LED, you lose here.
Well, like, why? If it doesn't kill the thing from below?
He gets 2 7/7s.
Yeah, but I have one taunt and I can deal
you can
10.
Roll spell power. Yeah, okay, you can roll taunt. Yeah, actually it's fine.
And, yeah, if it's just storm.
But if you don't hit spell power, you'll just go full face.
He also may not kill the Finn from the thing from below, it would be like pure disaster for him.
Yeah.
It was fine how we did it, I guess.
Yeah. You'll go full face though if you don't have spell power, and you'll probably lose the game to Halazil's power.
Okay, he set up the 7/7 town, it's over obviously.
They wouldn't rob this. Let me down totem or you lose. Shh. You'd have been 1 damage of leader with abusive top deck if.
If Thing from Bill would survive, I would have little, right?
1 damage off.
Even with the abusive?
Yeah.
It would be 7 and 10. He was at 18?
Yeah.
Okay, fine.
But you'd win because you'd have 2 taunts and you'd only have 7 direct damage.
Yeah.
He used all the damage spells. Yeah. He would need like Lava Shock.
Probably, okay. He would need Lava Shock. Okay, what do we have left? Shaman and Odiken has.
Druid and Warrior.
Warrior.
Okay. Can play whichever you want.
Yeah, whatever. Let's play the Shaman. It's more rewarding.
Yeah, I guess you don't want your OTK in the history turn.
Do I ever get Doomhammer?
With Trog on coin, I like it. Yeah.
Okay.
Because they don't have weapon removal. If they would have weapon removal, they would never.
Yeah,
do
obviously
it.
Then. If I he has Harrison, I would just have Doomhammer.
They full mold. Now they might have a shitty hand because they full mold. I like how they're like almost roping the fireworks. Does that say anything? They don't have an SS champion in their deck, so. You bolted.
I have to, right?
You can ignore it and
well, I can
back.
play Thing from Below the next turn. Or like you, like, ignore it. It's also not that bad, right?
But if you ignore it, you have to go with the Doom Hammer, and then you
like
don't
they
have
run
to
double
it.
Revenge. So I don't know how bad it is if they play Revenge. But it's not that bad, right? I just play Doom Hammer and kill it, right?
Ravaging Ghoul is pretty bad.
No, then,
you don't,
then I can
no.
also like kill the Acolyte with the Doomhammer.
Yeah, but you don't have follow-up to your Doomhammer. That's the only issue with Hammer.
Well, I have like a Bolt plus Flame Juggler.
Okay, ignore it.
Yes.
You would only kill it if you get a 1-1, I think.
Yeah.
Otherwise, I don't like killing Acolyte, because you want Hammer ASAP, because you
yeah,
only get 2 Hammers.
Yeah, especially with double Doomhammer, I need to set up it as soon as I can, right? Because...
Wow, he's scared. Do you ever kill the Bran with the hammer, or is it too much?
I will kill the Bran with the hammer, why not?
Yeah, it's fine, it's only 4 damage, yeah, it's cool.
Like, especially because now if he would play the Cartoon Buffer, he would be at 10.
Yeah, yeah.
And otherwise he has only 4 cards left, so he can be stacked, like...
Yeah, you kill the Bran for sure. You also, like, always want the board early game. I think you hero power over Flame Juggler. Because you want Thing from Below value?
Yeah, I have Lightning Bolt and hero power for sure.
Hammer is so great.
Okay. This was like a removal and 12 face damage. It's insane. Like, kill Bran 12 face.
You can go Flame Tongue, Hero Power, Thing from Below.
Yeah, it looks very good.
Do Hero Power first. Yeah, because you're on the taunt.
Yeah.
Okay. I don't mind playing the Thing from Below.
Yeah, I will, but I'm considering where.
No, on the left I meant. I think it's okay.
Don't you wanna ever put it next to Flame Tongue, because if he has Slam plus War Axe, he takes 2 extra?
Usually, but you also want to trade your Healing Totem away. But usually you play there, yeah. That's the usual spot. But I think if you ever want to trade the Healing Totem... And what's the chance of...
What's his Cartoon 6? Like, into what do I ever trade it?
Yeah, you have Axe too. Yeah, just play there. You also have Axe. Yeah. Second Doomhammer is also gonna be insane. Both Doomhammers deal 16. I mean, will deal 16. Like, what do they even want to target with that deck if they don't play weapon removal for their Shaman? How are they gonna beat Shaman?
Still for like 50-50, it's not bad, but it's really weird to ban Druid and not Ren Harrison.
Yeah, the lineup is bad, I would say.
Well, like, my lineup is something what they are hoping for, and they are still bad, yeah.
Yeah, you don't even have Dragon, you have OTK, which is like easier to target than.
Okay, what do we play here?
I mean, you need to play something to not extend that much.
I would play Flame Juggler, and if I hit, I will hit it with.
Yeah. You can also consider playing the second Doomhammer to not extend.
I will play the second Doomhammer, obviously. But I won't play the Flame Juggler, right?
Yeah, Flame Jugger is cool. The other line was like to play Hero Power.
And now I just kill the 3-3, right? Or do I just go full face? I can go full face,
I'll
right?
go full face. Your Hero Power, I think you can. You don't need to actually.
I just put a Doomhammer.
Oh yeah, I'm stupid, I'm stupid. Never mind. I'm sorry. Yeah. I was thinking you have infinite mana. The other line was to trade your thing from below and play the other second thing from below and Doomhammer. That makes his brawl a bit less good. But on this play is just better.
Seems to be better.
You cannot really invest to kill it, right? Or
So how much am I investing and what do I get?
you invest two stacks
Four.
of Doomhammer and Storm.
I guess Storm is zero investment, right? I guess. And two face of four, two Doomhammer charges. And for it, I got 5 power, 6 power on the board. It's not that relevant, right? So I just go face. And pass, right? I don't love a ball, lightning ball face, never ever.
Yeah. Still super early in the game. They might be able to outvalue their damage.
Like, they have the joystick or something. But they can
Fuck.
also lose on the board very easily.
Harder with Brawl, right? Brawl kind of like saves them a lot of times. Do you drop the horse rider? Not really, right? Or
Why
you want
not?
to? I'm just afraid of Brawl, but maybe I shouldn't be.
It's not that big, bro.
A square?
No, I
I
will
think
keep
you
the
can.
square.
Yeah, keep the square. You only have two times to attack, so maybe you wanna keep some things, some attacks. Because you want to double both Rock Biters ideally.
4.
Two Lava Bursts, one Rock Biter, one Bolt remaining. Dirty fuckers. I mean, you could have spell powered if you had spell power from the hero power.
Oh, I forgot how was bad.
You could trade the spell power and the horse rider, and then you could trade the
Then what, like?
thing from below and the one hit. Nah,
No.
this is probably better.
It was same,
You can hit face here. play Squire because you lose anyways if he has Brawn.
I need to be super lucky that Thing from Below wins the Brawn. But I will lose anyway, I guess, no matter what.
So I guess no Brawn?
Probably. This is good enough. I don't have Doom Hammers left. Maybe I need 7-7 or... And clear and try to win on the board, I guess. Yeah, it was bad.
He didn't draw your 7-7s, those are really important. And he drew like his good cards.
Yeah.
Don't even think they had Brawn.
He had a War Axe, right? That turned 2 also.
Yeah. He went War Axe into Acolyte, into Bran.
Okay.
Into Justicar. Yeah, the sweet curve. Now is the druid test.
So what's their druid? They have 6 drop instead of nourish, okay. You like everything?
So you keep Squire, you keep Tusker for sure. Do you wanna keep Flame Tongue too because you have the Tusker?
Yeah, then Thing from Below has to be good, like if I discount it for 2, right?
It's a pretty greedy keep. I'm not sure if you wanna keep Thing from Below and Flame Tongue.
So you would mulligan these 2?
Yeah.
It's also not bad, right?
They're really bad if they kill your minions with spells.
But like, the Flame Tongue has to be good. It's so good card against Druid, and like I have very good start.
Okay, you can keep the Flame Tongue, but I don't keep Thing. I don't like keeping Thing.
Yeah, okay, Thing is too greedy, I guess.
They full mulligan too. Okay. So now you Flame Tongue?
Probably, yeah, right?
Yeah, it's pretty strong. On that side?
Oh, that was a bad thing. Or was it like if they don't kill anything, then I played? Oh, it was bad, I guess. Or does it matter?
No, it doesn't matter that much. No, no, because you want the flame, you want the faceless on the left, right?
So yeah, that's why it is the reason that I imagine I will play the faceless on the left, and it's the best I can have, but.
Yeah, it's fine, it's fine. So they have swipe, now they need to have mulch.
And now the game is gonna be decided.
Oh, you have Totem Golem follow up, but... Yeah, they need mulch or they're pretty fucked. Do we ever trade her? I think you do, right? They used the swipe already. And
they can draft plus hero power though. But if they do it...
You have Storm. You could also like just go for a big Storm and win with Storm if they extend. So just go like, you can go Totem Golem.
But if they go like Power of the Wild and they can clear... Yeah, I would go Face probably.
I like Face too.
Like if I wouldn't have Storm, I wouldn't go Face, but... Yeah,
yeah, obviously, but that's the reason why. You might want to do it like this. It's pretty bad if they have mulch, but mulch has to be a top deck, so that's unlikely. Right, no Storm Bolt looks not bad. Storm Bolt and trade with Golem.
And ignore the Taurus and...
No, you bolt the Torison, right?
Oh.
You Storm Bolt.
Okay, now I see your point. And I will have 3-2, so how do I deal with 5-10?
I'm gonna have 3 mana next turn.
But I don't have a choice, right?
It's
I
super
can
good.
develop the Tusker instead of playing Storm.
And ignore the Emperor? I don't know.
Ignore the Emperor, yeah.
I wouldn't do that. You can develop Tusker next turn.
Okay, I agree.
Without fancy risks. It's super proactive because you can hit face for 7 again.
Yeah. It's good, like if they play the 5-10 then I can just trade it.
Yeah. It's only bad if they have mulch. Nourish is 4, so they can nourish into mulch, but that's actually not that bad.
No, it was like the most threatening this in this time. Yeah, wait.
Hero power. Okay.
So I just Tusker, right?
There's also some reasons for Ferals. You can like play Ferals. If you play Ferals, you can afford to attack with your guy. And then like...
Oh, it's true. Like, if they don't have removal... Then I will go 7 face, and otherwise they will just trade the 7s. And the Ferals are good, yeah, I agree. Let's play the Ferals.
Yeah. You still need to like hit the juggle to get to be in a good spot, but you still have Tusker too.
No, I can kill it with the 2/3 and go 7 phase, like it will be great.
Yeah, but you don't want to invest 2/3s.
Yeah, like obviously, like it would be like a dream if I wouldn't have to. Okay, this was better.
Okay, at least now you kill one.
Okay, I will play Tusker plus Flame Juggler every day, right?
Yes.
So where do I want him? Does it matter?
I think you want him near the...
I will start with this, right? Every time.
Yeah. But you probably want him near the...
Like,
seven.
Now I will put it here, like, to trade a 7-2. It's Flame Tonk.
Yeah.
Okay.
You still trade a 5-9, right?
Yeah.
It's okay.
Trade this away.
Their hand is really fucking good again. You can play your whole hand, maybe. Yeah, and you play the Flame Tank too, right? Or you don't want to?
That's what I'm curious about. Why?
I like it, because...
Like,
it's only bad if they have Living Roots.
Yeah.
And... protects your guy.
I don't feel it protects my guy that well. And against Yoke, let's say it's bad to have it on the board.
What if he hero powers your 5/5?
Then he deals 2 extra damage, but like if he has Yoke, Living Roots. It's like.
He would have used the Roots last time, I think. But you can play square, I think it's fine.
Like, I will for sure play the square, but... Hmm. Yeah, it's something I don't know, like... Hmm.
Their hand was insane, though, like...
It wasn't that insane, like, they didn't have Wild Grow, right, or did they?
It had Innervates. Innervated Teacher. Innervating Mire Keeper, sorry. Yeah, the Innervating Mire Keeper and on 2, so it's even better than Wild Growth.
Yeah, it's better than Wild Growth, that's true.
Neither Doomhammer
Yeah,
faster.
it's better that I didn't have the Doomhammer when they have the 5-1. Like, it was.
They also fucking Raven idle the swipe, so that's like a meme.
Yeah, here it was very crucial. Like, if he wouldn't have swipe here, he would be in troubles as well. Like, whatever. It's happening. Screw it. GG, right? I don't have AK here. Yeah, whatever. It was normal. So I 0-3 with the shaman, right? Or yeah. Okay, shaman OP class. It's weird. Like I'm losing with against warriors. Like against captains, but the AI will ban the class against most of the players.
Hey.
Hi.
Hi.
Do you wanna look at some of the place now?
I don't know, like I'm pretty tired. It was like 2 hours
I'm
already.
super tired too.
So,
Sure.
like,
We can look at them like tomorrow if you guys want.
Yeah, we can. Whoa.
Yeah, sure. You, Stensifier, you're taking like recording of your screen, is that?
Yeah, I have the OBS, so I have all the games recorded.
Well, I'll have to go to work tomorrow, but maybe you could just like send them to me because I don't know.
It's super big.
Oh, it's super big. Yeah. Okay, then never mind.
Maybe like I can up try to upload it on YouTube or whatever. Yeah, that's something I can do. I can upload it.
Yeah, okay. All
Okay.
right, that would be nice, but if it's not possible, no problem at
I
all.
will probably do it. Okay, so it's
I
fine. Like
mean,
it's also not bad for my channel because it's quite interesting.
yeah.
So I will just upload it. Okay, so yeah, we can play tomorrow again.
Yeah.
Okay, so see you soon.
See you soon.